A few players in this game absolutely went off. And we had guys on either team go off. Several guys. In particular, you got Adam Gaudette, you got Brady Tkachuk, you got Craig Anderson, you got SVEN BAERTSCHI, you got Anisimov. Some of these guys just went off. And overall, the Vancouver Canucks lose this one. It's kind of bad. Statistically speaking, it's kind of bad. It's a 6-2 loss in Rogers Arena. After the Vancouver Canucks scored two goals to kick off the first period, they end up getting six straight scored against them and losing. So that's nice. But overall, let's go over this game in general. The Canucks weren't as bad as the score sheet suggests, nor do I believe that Demko was as bad as the score sheet suggests. Now, he did have a few bad bounces here and there, a few pucks that probably should have been saved by him, but were easy goals for the other team. And in particular, the last goal scored in the game with like 2 seconds left on the power play, Demko was sprawled out, he had the puck on his glove, and instead of covering it, he accidentally pushed the puck over to the side, and that was just completely unlucky for him, which went to an open Brady Tkachuk and he potted it in. But I will say for Demko, this is the kind of game that you want out of Demko. You want a bad game like this, a game where I don't think he was bad, but a game where he had those bad bounces, because you want him to experience that. You want this to get done in the preseason, so that by the time Demko is full-time NHL, it's the regular season. Hopefully, the philosophy is those bad bounces, they stop happening. Now, that's not any security to prevent that from happening, but I'm just saying I would rather have Demko give up these bad bounces now rather than in 2 weeks from now. Does that kind of make sense? Okay, Demko was not bad. It's just that the bounces were really unfortunate and really prevalent too. So he definitely could have had a better game, but I don't want to say he was poor. As for the other goalie, though, my goodness, Craig Anderson. Wow, I didn't realize he had that in him. 44 saves out of Craig Anderson. The guy is like 38 years old, and he's coming in here making these saves. The Canucks had 46 shots on net, and Craig Anderson stopped almost all of them. Crazy, crazy good performance by him. And overall, he was just a stud in net, covering up those pucks, taking those long slap shots, absorbing those shots on the rush. He did a fantastic job shutting down the Vancouver Canucks post Adam Gaudette and SVEN BAERTSCHI. His save percentage was much, much better than Demko's, as Demko only had 29 shots against, and he made 23 saves. So yeah, that's not that great, but oh well, let's move on. Let's actually talk about the goals in this one. Adam Gaudette strikes first, and this one comes because SVEN BAERTSCHI is in the passing lane as the Ottawa Senators are trying to break the puck out of their own zone. The pass is trying to go over the blue line and to the other guy wing to wing, but BAERTSCHI is at that blue line, and he knocks the puck down, sends it over to Gaudette, who's right there with some open space. He shoots it, he scores. Gaudette with his fourth of the preseason. We talk about guys who have been fighting their way to making the Vancouver Canucks, and Gaudette is the guy who is leading that train. I think he's tied, or he has the most goals in the preseason out of everybody. I'm pretty sure that's the case. I'm not really too sure about that, but Gaudette has been amazing. He's had so many goals. This was his fourth, and it was just a really nice setup from BAERTSCHI. We had some chemistry there with that line, as we saw just a few minutes later in the period, as later on, it's SVEN BAERTSCHI who gets a goal from Adam Gaudette. This one happens because Gaudette steals the puck as the Ottawa Senators are trying to break it out. They break it out of their zone, it's in the neutral zone, and Gaudette swoops in, picks it up, he dashes into the zone, and drops it back off with a nice little fake. BAERTSCHI is there, picks it up, he shoots, he scores. Great confidence there from those two. BAERTSCHI, on his playmaking to the Gaudette goal, he displayed some really good poise and calmness. Gaudette, on his playmaking pass over to the BAERTSCHI goal, Gaudette displayed some really nice, crafty almost kind of cheeky playmaking over there. It was really nice to see. And honestly, that's pretty much it. That's all we had for Vancouver Canucks goals. Going over the Senators goals though, Connor Brown had a really nice one. That one was a goal where the puck was stolen off of Bo Horvat. Brady Tkachuk got himself two goals here. Artem Anisimov had a goal. Anisimov was there. Yeah, it's Anisimov again. I didn't realize this guy was a Senator, but Chabot and Shalapik also got goals as well for the Sens, and I wanted to talk a little bit about just some of the players that we saw for the Vancouver Canucks. Obviously, going over the Sens, Brady Tkachuk was an absolute beast, two goals, two assists, and he was just so all over the puck everywhere. The guy couldn't calm down, he was just all over the Canucks, it was frustrating as heck. But for the Vancouver Canucks side of things, I wanted to talk a little bit about Quinn Hughes. Hughes was played a lot. I will say that right now. Hughes had 25 minutes of ice time. And as a guy who's only 19, you don't really expect that. And I think it was a really good decision to give Hughes this amount of ice time, because it gives him an idea of how he needs to play if he wants to maintain the play for that long. Assuming Travis Green is going to go with Quinn Hughes for that long, and maybe once in a while give him that role where he is playing 23 minutes plus a night, Hughes needs to understand how that feels. And I will say, first and foremost, that I think Hughes was going through those growing pains. There were some moments throughout this game where he didn't look too great. There were a lot of icings done by Quinn Hughes, a lot of long lob passes that didn't find the mark. A lot of moves where Quinn Hughes was trying to take the puck into the zone himself, only to get stripped away. Sure, he had a lot of moments where that specific play worked, but for the most part, Hughes wasn't perfect. And that's fine. It's the preseason, so we're not gonna pretend like they are needing to be perfect at this point. Save it for the regular season. But Quinn Hughes playing in this game for 25 minutes was a staple to me that says that Travis Green is willing to trust the guy. On the power play, Quinn Hughes was cycling it. He had some confidence out there. He could go by guys. He was deking by guys. And in terms of the power play time on ice, Quinn Hughes was out there for 5 minutes. That's incredibly long. He was out there for so long, and he had so much time to really absorb the NHL game at NHL speeds for this long. And I can't stress that enough. He played for such a long time, which was a good thing in my opinion, but overall, Hughes showed some of the wear and tear that you will get from a 19-year-old playing 25 minutes a night in the NHL, so I just hope that he's able to get past that. And as the game did go on, I did see Hughes get a little bit more safer, a little bit more calmer, and a little bit more productive with the puck overall. The same thing with Demko. I don't think he played a perfect game, but overall, what we did see was fairly positive for growth. Now, some of the other guys we had here, I wanted to talk about JT Miller. Man, the guy is lethal. He's absolutely lethal. He's so dynamic. I didn't realize that JT Miller had the ability to stop on a dime, deke past guys, and set up plays the way that he was doing this game. JT Miller was so effective, and I was such a big fan of what he did this game, that I'm so looking forward to seeing what he'll be able to do with Horvat full-time for 82 games this upcoming season. As for some of the other guys that stood out to me, Nikolai Goldobin, the man's a playmaker. He's crazy good when he's breaking into the zone and setting guys up. When he gets a pass off, it's usually on the right track. And that usually only happens when Goldobin has the confidence to skate the puck in himself, and once in the offensive zone, find a guy to pass it to. A lot of his breakout passes in the neutral zone were weak and they got blocked, but when Goldobin puts on the moves and he gets by a guy or two, that's when he really starts to show off that skill. And I will admit, I didn't really notice too much of Goldobin on the back check or in the defensive zone, but coming down on the rush, that's when I really noticed. Goldobin's great, man. We've been saying this for a long time, Goldobin has elite playmaking talent. It's just that everything else around that is a question mark. And I hope he's able to fix that, because I want to see more of that awesome playmaking. But overall, the big ones coming out of this game, it's SVEN BAERTSCHI, Adam Gaudette. They got that chemistry going. Gaudette is tied for the league lead or second or third or whatever. He's one of the top goal scorers in the league for the preseason. He's been doing great. I hope he earns a spot in this team. And overall, Thatcher Demko and Quinn Hughes, sure, you guys weren't amazing, but it's good to have these games now rather than 2 weeks from now. I hope you enjoyed this video. And bye.